Harlem streets stay flooded in white powder, like those motherfuckers running away from the Twin Towers. Gunshots rock the earth like a meteor shower. Bowling for Columbine Fair, giving the media power. Innocence devoured like a chicken spot snack box. Government cocaine cooked into ghetto crack rock. Corrupt cops, false testimony at your arraignment. Check the check, constant struggle to make the payments. Working your whole life wondering where the day went. The subway stays packed like a multicultural slave ship. It's rush hour, 2:30 to 8 non-stopping, and people coming home after corporate sharecropping. And fuck flossing, mothers are trying to feed children, but gentrification is kicking them out of their building. A generation of babies born without healthcare, families homeless, thrown the fuck off the welfare. The killing fields uptown. We live in distress and hang the flag upside down. The sound of conservative politicians on television. People in the hood are blind, so they tell us to listen. They vote for us to go to war instantly, but none of their kids serving the infantry. The odds are stacked against us like a casino. Think about it, most of the army is black and Latino. And if you can't acknowledge the reality of my words, you just another stupid motherfucker out on the curb, trying to escape from the ghetto with your ignorant ways. But you can't read history at an illiterate stage, and you can't raise a family on minimum wage. Why the fuck you think most of us are locked in a cage? I give niggas the truth, cause they pride is indigent. You better off rich and guilty than poor and innocent. But I'm sick of feeling impotent, watching the world burn. In the era of apocalypse, waiting my turn. I'm a Harlem nigga that's concerned with the future, and if you're in my way, it'd be an honor to shoot ya. Uproot ya with the evil that grows in my people, making them deceitful, cannibalistic and lethal. But I see through the mentality implanted in us, and I educate my fam about who we should trust.
Homicide Harlem, Blair, what's the problem? Homicide Harlem, Blair, what's the problem? Homicide Harlem, Blair, what's the problem?
Freedom of speech, motherfucker.
I got no string to hold me down to make me fit.
Something for the kids. Step in the club smoothly with the L in my hand. Bitches know that I'm a freak like the Elephant Man. Intelligent plans, fuck a record deal. I want development land with my benevolent clan. And that's the reason that I only trust my fam. 40,000 records sold, 400 grand. Fuck a middleman, I won't pay anyone else. I'll bootleg it and sell it to the streets myself. I'd rather be that than signed and stuck on a shelf. And because of this, executives try to diss me. Racism frozen in time like Walt Disney. And now they say they wanna get me signed to the major. If I switch up my politics and change my behavior, trying to tell me what the rhyme about over the beat. Bitch niggas that never spent a day in the street. But I repeat that, nobody can hold my reins. I put the truth on tracks, niggas, simple and plain.
I got no strings, so I have fun. I'm not tied up to anyone. Take that string, but you can see there are no strings on me.
I guess to America, I'm a disaster. Oh, no. A slave that was destined to own his masters. Independent in every single sense of the word. I say what I want, you fucking little sensitive herb. This is America. I thought we had freedom of speech, but now you wanna try to control the way that I speak. And O'Reilly, you think you a patriot?
Yeah, right.
You ain't nothing but a motherfucking racist bitch, full of hatred, pressing a button, trying to eject me. But I don't got no motherfucking deal with Pepsi. No corporate sponsor telling me what to do, asking me to tone it down during an interview. Trying to minimize the issue, but I'm keeping it large. I love the place I live, but I hate the people in charge. Speaking is hard when you got strings attached, so I'ma say it for you, cause I don't got none of that. And if you didn't understand what I spit at your brain, hey yo son, let this little nigga explain. Come on, son, y'all niggas know the way that I do. ImmortalTechnique.com live for you. And I know sometimes it be making you nervous, the way I smash puppet rappers that belong in a circus. You motherfuckers just can't compare. Looking for a fan base that's no longer there. I know that you're scared and you're hiding up in the cut, but this is freedom of speech, nigga, tell them what's up. Word, nigga, fuck John Ashcroft. Nigga, fuck Fox News. Fuck those snake ass bitches trying to manipulate your opinion, telling you what to think. Word the fuck up, nigga. Like, we invading niggas cause we wanna free them. You racist motherfucker. You don't give a shit about those people. You can suck my dick.
Relax, Tech, relax.
Another rum and coke at the bar, nigga. It's my day off. Word up. Fuck. For the kids. Ah! For the kids.
Yo, son, give me that newspaper.
Yeah, here you go.
Man, I hate this one, yo. You know, the Post is always on some biased, racist bullshit, man.
Word,
that in the Daily News.
I feel you.
It's ridiculous, man. Time's a little better, but he's still on some bullshit.
I know that, man.
Another nigga killed by these fucking cops, yo.
What?
Word? See, that's why I gotta get the fuck out of here, man. I need some fucking peace. I need
something,
man.
Son.
Either that, I'm gonna
bounce,
start
yo.
Just blasting these fucking pigs, man.
For real, yo.
Yo, son, fuck it, let's do something, man. Let's see some mommies out there.
You know what? Matter of fact, pack the bags.
All right, then.
That's start the suck. Fucking whip up.
Right.
I'm out of here, yo. For real.
I hate my job, so I always look to a better day. Far from New York City on a tropical getaway, but not in Miami, cause these white Cuban anti-Castros can't stand me. And that's the reason I'll never win a fixed up Latin Grammy. After this, racist Latinos are goddamn me. But my black people love me, and when I go to South America, people be trying to hug me, cause I talk about reality that affects them. And even though I blew up, I could never neglect them. What kind of revolutionary action would that be? I'd be categorizing practically every other MC, but never that, cause I'm clever with facts. Sever your raps, you fake players and thugs will forever be whack. I'm still rolling with my squadron, heavily strapped, and even if I get killed, I'll inevitably be back. Encyclopedia Hispanic or over digital debt. Don't ever compare me to small-minded criminal cats. I kill kids on tracks like Dale Earnhardt. Spit in your face and leave your cheekbone with a burn mark. I was born a genius, but I learned to be street smart. My vacation just started. I'm out to the Caribbean swimming in Dominican women the color of cinnamon. You motherfuckers wish you had the lifestyle I'm living in.
Yo, yo.
East Coast to West Coast and everything in between. This is dedicated to everybody chasing their dreams. This ghetto fabulous life really ain't what it seems, but I'ma make it cause I got survival stuck in my genes. East Coast to West Coast and everything in between. This is dedicated to everybody chasing their dreams. This ghetto fabulous life really ain't what it seems, but I'ma make it cause I got survival stuck in my genes.
Word up, word.
Immortal Technique, representing Harlem, all the way out to my fam in Englewood. I'm out, motherfucker.
Get away, nigga.
Look, let me make something abundantly clear for people that are so bereft of activities, they feel like they gotta comment on every one of mine. First of all, being a vegetarian should never be associated with being a revolutionary or being open-minded.
that's a dietary choice. If someone wants to proliferate the type of ignorance we're supposed to be fighting by thinking that, you're just fucking yourself. I don't go around promoting beef and poultry, shoving it in people's faces. I don't castigate people for not eating steak sandwiches. And I would never diss someone for being a fucking broccoli head, or living off radishes, or eating grass with tofu. I like a lot of vegan cuisine, but the illogicality of expecting everyone to adopt your particular idea of what being healthy is just preposterous. I've seen some of you herbivores, and if you want to argue health, y'all need to eat some kind of supplement, cause some of y'all are so skinny that it's disgusting, looking like the only hip-hop motherfuckers on Schindler's List. Being a malnutrition ass got nothing to do with being revolutionary or being on point. I'll be damned if I let somebody else push their agenda on me. You know, I don't eat pork, not cause I'm a Muslim, I just don't really like it, but I really will fuck a bird up. And fish is good when that shit is fresh. It's like my nigga Vast Air from Can Oxet. If you don't like the smell of burning meat, then get the fuck off the planet. You know, I don't criticize people for eating moss. Man, don't open your fucking mouth about my food, man. I like beef and broccoli, motherfucker. Mind your goddamn business. Matter of fact, you know what? I'm out. I feel like some arroz con pollo, a banana daiquiri, and a motherfucking bistec apanado. So you the motherfucker they call Immortal Technique. What the fuck make you so special, nigga? The fuck do you do?
I calculate planet alignment like Mayan astronomy, discovering atrocities worse than Aristotle, subjecting children to sodomy. Your theory of the galaxy is primitive like Ptolemy. The truth about the universe dug up like Aztec pottery. Unpredictable results like experimental psychology. I storm the streets with MCs beneath my feet in colonies, but presentation and spirit revolve around autonomy, searching for monogamy and cutting fake bitches out of my mind like a lobotomy. So obviously, I'm not gonna be here to play games, walk the top of the world and leave the Arctic Circle in flames. Battle the beast and false prophet depicted in the King James. I give a fuck about your MC name, I don't admire you. Only by dental records would you be identifiable, cause the future is not reliable. Remember when rap was not economically viable, comparable to what motherfuckers think of me. I might be nobody, but wait till I'm together like a symphony, resounding sound that will continue infinitely. Angel of death punishing all those who live in infamy and shine so far away from you, you'll never get a glimpse of me. Attempts to extinguish me don't even bother me none, like retarded kids throwing ice cubes at the sun. A victory against Immortal Technique will never be done, just degrees of losing and every second you're adding one. Some niggas dream of pushing kilos, but I drop tons of more facts, formulas and philosophical logic than a basement full of scientists puffing on chronic. Dip the mic in potassium cyanide and liquid bubonic and use it as a sonic wand to find a spawn of the demonic. Screaming like onyx is of absolutely no consequence, the poison is dense enough to clog up your arteries. Mercy is not a part of me. I cause you bodily injury permanently, because simply verbally murdering me is inconceivable because of the unbelievable evil injected inside the bloodstream of my people. And redemption is not located under a church steeple. The feeble and the meek and soldiers like the technique will inherit the earth, but the earth will be weak. Mother Earth and her decrepit terminal illness physique. The year 3000 is bleak, no happily ever after, just death following the Fourth Reich disaster. A legacy of bastards with plastic explosives. Your future's been eroded cause you forgot that when you're free, it's multiplied indefinitely by the struggle that be. The struggle I see to socialistically unite the third world countries, expose hypocrisy in America's democracy. Sloppily obsessed with stopping me cause I speak prophecy, trample and dismantle your capitalist philosophy, the same way I stomp the conquering rap monopoly. And I'm not a fucking prophet, but that's the fucking prophecy.
Thank you. I once knew a nigga whose real name was William. His primary concern was making a million, being the illest hustler that the world ever seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son's heart simultaneously grew colder. He started hanging out, selling bags in the projects, checking the young chicks, looking for hit and run prospects. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation cause he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. So criminals he chilled with didn't think he was real. You see, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. He fiended for props like addicts with pipes and needles, and so he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential, the product of a ghetto-bred capitalistic mental. Coincidentally, dropped out of school to sell weed, dancing with the devil, smoked until his eyes would bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave in to his greed. Everyone trying to be trife, never face the consequences. You probably only did a month for minor offenses. Ask a nigga doing life if he had another chance. But then again, there's always the wicked that knew in advance. Dance forever with the devil on a cold cell block. But that's what happens when you rape, murder, and sell rock. Devils used to be gods, angels that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So Billy started robbing niggas anything he could do. Get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Starting fights over little shit up on the block. Stepped up to selling mothers and brothers the crack rock. Working overtime, making money for the crack spot. Hit the jackpot and wanted to move up to cocaine. Fulfilling the Scarface fantasy stuck in his brain. Tired of the block niggas treating him the same. He wanted to be major like the cutthroats and the thugs. But when he tried to step to him, niggas showed him no love. They told him any motherfucking coward can sell drugs. Any bitch nigga with a gun can bust slugs. Any nigga with a red shirt can front like a blood. Even Puffy smoked the motherfucker up in the club. But only a real thug can stab someone till they die. Standing in front of them, staring straight into their eyes, Billy realized that these men were well guarded. And they wanted to test him before business started. Suggested raping a bitch to prove he was cold-hearted. So now he had a choice between going back to his life or making money with made men up in the scythe. His dreams about cars and ice made him agree. A hardcore nigga is all he ever wanted to be. And so he met them Friday night at 2:45. Everyone trying to be trife, never face the consequences. You probably only did a month for minor offenses. Ask a nigga doing life if he had another chance. But then again, there's always the wicked that knew in advance. Dance forever with the devil on a cold cell block. But that's what happens when you rape, murder, and sell rock. Devils used to be gods, angels that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. They drove around the project slow while it was raining, smoking blunts, drinking, and joking for entertainment. Until they saw a woman on the street walking alone, 3 a.m, coming back from work on her way home. And so they quietly got out the car and followed her. Walking through the projects, the darkness swallowed her. They wrapped a shirt around their head and knocked her onto the floor. This is it, kid, now you got your chance to be raw. So Billy yoked her up and grabbed the chick by the hair and dragged her into a lobby that had nobody there. She struggled hard, but they forced her to go up the stairs. They got to the roof and then held her down on the ground, screaming, "Shut the fuck up and stop moving around." The shirt covered her face, but she screamed and clawed. So Billy stomped on the bitch till he broke in her jaw. Them dirty bastards knew exactly what they were doing. They kicked her until they cracked her ribs and she stopped moving. Blood leaking through the cloth, she cried silently. And then they all proceeded to rape her violently. Billy was made to go first, but each of them took a turn, ripping her up and choking her until her throat burned. Her broken jaw mumbled for God, but they weren't concerned. When they were done and she was lying bloody, broken and bruised, one of them niggas pulled out a brand new 22. They told him that she was a witness for what she'd gone through, and if he killed her, he was guaranteed a spot in the crew. He thought about it for a minute, she was practically dead, and so he leaned over and put the gun right to her head. He pulled the trigger and ended a life. He thought about the cocaine with the platinum and ice, and he felt strong standing along with his new brothers. Cocked the gat to a head and pulled back the shirt cover, but what he saw made him start to cringe and stutter, cause he was staring into the eyes of his own mother. She looked back at him and cried cause he had forsaken her. She cried more painfully, and when they were raping her, his whole world stopped. He couldn't even contemplate. His corruption had successfully changed his fate, and he remembered how his mom used to come home late, working hard for nothing, cause now what was he worth? He turned away from the woman that had once given him birth, and crying out to the sky cause he was lonely and scared. But only the devil responded cause God wasn't there. And right then he knew what it was to be empty and cold, and so he jumped off the roof and died with no soul. They say death takes you to a better place, but I doubt it. After that they killed his mother and never spoke about it. And listen, cause the story that I'm telling is true, cause I was there with Billy Jacobs and I raped his mom too. And now the devil follows me everywhere that I go. In fact, I'm sure he's standing among one of you at my shows, in every street cypher listening to Little Thug's flow. He could be standing right next to you and you wouldn't know. The devil grows inside the hearts of the selfish and wicked. White, brown, yellow, and black color is not restricted. You have a self-destructive destiny when you're inflicted, and you'll be one of God's children that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So when the devil wants to dance with you, you better say never, because a dance with the devil might last you forever.
Motherfuckers thought it was over, huh? But it's not. You didn't count on a fallen angel getting back into the grace of God and coming after you. Y'all niggas ain't shit. Your producers ain't shit. Your fucking A&R ain't shit. I'll fucking wipe my ass with your demo deal. Yo, Diabolik, take this motherfucker's head off!
Go ahead and grip blocks. I'll snap your trigger finger in six spots. You'll have to lip lock with hypodermic needles to lick shots. I'll watch you topple flat. Put away your writtens and holler back. Can't freestyle, you're screwed off the top like bottle caps. Beneath the surface, I'm overheating your receiver circuits by unleashing deeper verses than pre-speaking churches. What you preach is worthless. Your worship defeat the purpose, like President Bush taking bullets for the Secret Service. Beyond what y'all fathom, I shit on cats and jaw tap them. Show no compassion like having a straight-faced orgasm. Tour jack him, have his half a 10 bitch suck my friend's dick. In the meantime, you could French kiss this clenched fist. Diabolik, a one-man brigade spreading cancer plague. Fist fucking a pussy's face, holding a hand grenade. So if I catch you bluffing, faggot, you're less than nothing. I just had to get that stress off my chest like breast reduction.
You motherfuckers are nothing. You cannot harm me. I'll resurrect every aborted baby and start an army. Storm the planet, hunting you down, cause I'm on a mission to split your body into a billion one-celled organisms. Immortal technique could destroy your religion, you stupid bitch. You're faker than blue-eyed crackers nailed to a crucifix. I'm about to blow up like NASA Challenger computer chips. Arsenic language transmitted revolutionarily. I'm like time itself, I'm gonna kill you inevitably. Chemically bomb you, fuck using a chrome piece. I'm Illmatic, you won't make it home like Jerome's niece. I'll sever your head diagonally for thinking of dissing me, and then use your dead body to write my name in calligraphy. This puppet democracy brainwashed your psychology, so you're nothing like diversity without equality. And your crew is full of more faggots than Greek mythology. Using numerology to count the people I sent to heaven produces more digits than 22 divided by 7. You like Kevin Spacey, your style is usually suspect. You never killed a cop, you not a motherfucking thug yet. Your mind is empty and spacious, like the part of the brain that appreciates culture in a racist. Face it, you're too basic, you never gonna make it. Like children walking through Antarctica, butt naked.